Hello, multi-millennium members. Ralfy here with Ralfy Review 741, and a big multi-mention thank you to Radio Laboratory for that mock mention. Welcome. I'm Ralfy. This is the Bothy. This is the single malt. I am going to smell it, taste it, tell you all about it. Then, of course, you know what's coming next. A malt mark. Wonderful. First things first. Let me introduce to you a single malt that I am happy to review, rate and recommend to you. It's from the Isle of Arran, a relatively modern distillery in Scotland, proving that modern distilleries can produce great single malt whisky. This is not peated. It is a lowland whisky made on an island, the island of Arran. I knew you'd guess that. And this particular version, because you've got quite an extensive range of Isle of Arran malts out there from the 10, 12, 14, 16, 18 year old, a number of really good quality independent bottlings, and a peated version of Arran called Machrymore. But in this particular instance, I'm going to focus on a recent release from this distillery, which I find quite noteworthy. It is a 10th anniversary bottling selected by the distillery manager to commemorate his time at the distillery and the fact that he has been working in the whisky industry for 40 years and frankly has a shitload of experience regarding all things malty. There we go. So here he is, James McTaggart, nicely silhouetted on this presentation box. I shall open it up. There we go. Gives you a wee bit of legend about James. Nice classy cardboard. Yep. So still recyclable. Good quality. Gift. Definitely gift standard single malt. Not too expensive. It's 10 years old. 10th anniversary. 10 years old. All ties in. It's bottled at a cask strength of 54.2%. It is natural colour. It is unchill filtered. And the legend inside the box is stating basically that James has gone through the warehouses. And nobody knows, particularly in small distilleries, nobody knows warehouses better than the person who's buying the casks, selecting the casks, filling the casks, making the stuff and supervising it all. Simple as that. And I think in this instance, you have a genuinely top flight version of Arran at a relatively young age, which is, although spirit driven, it has a wonderful complexity and a restrained maturity about it, which elevates it beyond its 10 years in the cask. I shall smell it now. Tell you a little bit more. Lovely, complex, fragrant, slightly floral, sweet and sour with bananas and a little bit of table salt on the nose as well. Although funnily enough, saltiness is something you generally get more strongly on the palate rather than the smell. But smelling this, you're immediately struck by the intensity of it. Bear in mind, this is cask strength. This is a relatively young single malt. So it doesn't have a lot of corners to hide in that you can get with old whiskies and vintage casks. The quality is going to show itself either way fairly early on, and on the nose, first impressions are really quite positive. Taste, bear in mind, 54.2%. This is heavy duty stuff. It's intense, but it's not a huge amount of nip. It's as if the alcohol's really filled up with flavour, such as the quality of the casks, and you do get that from quality casks, fresh ex-bourbon casks. even neat. This is a delightful, fresh fruit single malt experience. Now, let's add some water. And I'm going to add, from the silver spoon, quite a lot of water. I could literally double the volume of that whiskey with water and it would still shine. It would still be intense, full flavoured. There's nothing fragile or flimsy or delicate about this. When you add water, before too long you get this delightful minty, slightly pineapple resinous with some underripe, slightly green banana and papaya in it. A delicious, well, when I say delicious, nose delicious. Bear with me. A most delicious complexity in the nose. For such a young single malt, it's frankly a star. It's one of the best Arrans I've ever tasted, actually. It's limited edition, but be reassured. This isn't limited edition to 120 bottles or 1,200 bottles. It's 12,000 bottles from a distillery that is not sought after, collectible, investable. That's good news for whiskey drinkers, seriously, because you don't have a feeding frenzy of opportunists looking to cash in on inflated single malt values. And we're increasingly noticing this and having to pick our purchases carefully to avoid these overbranded whiskies. Not in the case of Arran. You're on safe ground with Arran. It hasn't become a snob's malt, but it has become a connoisseur's malt, a real anorak's malt, because they are carefully, they didn't get off to a great start, to be honest. In the early days, the non-age statement versions could be really more miss than hit, but with experience, generally at the distillery, but also the experience of having experienced industry people who are not showmen, who are not showboaters, who are not cheermeisters. They're just quiet, unassuming professionals. And I'm going to come back to this in my extras, because this really matters. Got to be aware of this, the enhanced whiskey knowledge. But I'll leave that for extras. Back to the malt. Taste. It's had a few minutes in the glass with water, plenty of it to open up. Bright, fresh, sherbety, a rich, warm, almost gingery vanilla note with ultra rich sultanas, the bananas there, the pineapples there, the papaya in the background, emphasizing that bitterness, that subtle complexity of the sensations, sweet, sour, salt. There is saltiness in there, delightful, soft, integrated saltiness, savoury and, what was it, sweet, sour, bitter, salt and savoury. It's all in here at 10 years old. So you have a young single malt which carries itself way beyond its years of bottling. And that's not something you find common in whisky these days. And I really must commend Arran. Arran have got an absolute five-star sippers single malt here. It really shows. Now, I'll finish off now by going arrival, development and the finish before the malt marks. Arrival. Once you add water, beautifully paced, displaying all the sensations, carrying that delightful fresh fruit, floral, herbal complexity, not a lot of spice. Development is rich, complex. When you take your time, when you slow the whole event down in your palate, you are picking up on the floral notes, the savoury notes, the herbal notes, little touch of sage in there, and the wintergreen, the phenolics and the mints, and the delicate, subtle, honeyed sweetness that's in the background, balancing off beautifully into a finish of fresh brewed tea, sustaining, complex, long, some bitter lemon in that finish, which is nothing short of exquisite. I gotta stop there. I don't want to get too carried away with this. Where's the malt marks? Bring out the malt marks. Time for the malt marks. It's got to be 90 out of 100. It's a malt mark. That's what it is. For the James McTaggart bottling of Arran, Isle of Arran, single malt whisky, 10th anniversary. In other words, an experienced professional has been left to get on with bottling what he wants to bottle. He knows the best of what this Arran can deliver, and he has delivered it comprehensively and very successfully. This, you can talk about industry professionals, but when the best endorsement that any industry professional can get is when the years of experience and their commitment to their profession shows in what they bottle and is appreciated by those who genuinely love single malt whisky and the exploration. Every now again, as we explore the rich treasure trove of quality spirits from around the world, we uncover a diamond, a ruby, a sapphire, an emerald, whatever, that has that additional sparkle. And this maltster's is a very good example of that. I'm Ralphy. Thank you for watching. I hope you'll join me again for Ralphy Reviews Extras 741, in which I will talk about what to look for in industry professionals and also some advice for distilleries. Take note, distilleries.